used to be so happy, but without you here, I feel so low. I watch you as you left, but I can never seem to let you go. Cause once upon a time, you were my everything. It's clear to see that time hasn't changed a thing. It's very deep inside me, but I feel there's something you should know. Apparently they've forced this pressure of the team and said, yeah, just, you can have 5 to 10 minutes or something like that. Yeah, I saw that. Got a little notification on my screen saying, ooh, Vin's just started streaming. Yeah. Am I like your only subscriber? I get it even for your, like, shitty test streams as well. Yep. If they're, like, active and anyone can see them. So, who's gonna win? This is the question on everybody's mind right now. This is obviously a very difficult game to select the winner. As the players storm in.
At least you've got a full team.
That they do. I tried to trade for Diggs just before and I said, no, you can't do that. Because you can't make trades after the first game of the week has started. They have to wait until the last game of the week's been played.
That's fair enough.
It stops, you know, a player playing like 4 games in a week.
So, who we've got? We've got Dokugan, Borless, Squash, and A for Charlie Sheen. And Timmy Cahill, Peter, Jipru, and Elaine.
I believe that's Jeremy, yeah.
For the Vulcanists. Predictions, who?
I think Charlie Sheen will win. They have better players.
Timmy's asking for a handicap of +5 for the Vulcanists, and I'm not too sure whether that's going to help them.
Yeah, I think they'll need a bit more than that. Can we use timers? Teams are ready, and we are ready to go.
Looks like Shandor and Acti would like to con. They aren't spectators, so.
Go, go!
I'll assume that they are. But, hang on, I'll just check.
Hey, man. Streaming?
We are streaming. We're live cool. Right now.
I'm gonna move in.
Alright, ready to go. And we got Mr. Me here there to help us out in the commentary box.
I am commentating.
Balls with an easy grab against Jeremy and Peter. He's going to make a good handoff and now A is away. The boost spawns, but he doesn't take it. Probably came up a little bit too late for him. He's ahead of two, come into base, takes the boost, gets past Gepru. Peter gets returned. Timmy gets returned. Blocks on Jeremy, blocks on Gepru. That's a cap. 1-0. That was in less than 30 seconds. And it might be a second.
It looks like it could be. It is.
Boss is coming in. He will get the cap. But now Timmy Cahill's ahead of three.
Not anymore.
Dokugan comes in huge. Gets that return. Less than 40 seconds has passed. And it's already 2-0. It's not looking good for the Vulcanists right now. Just, you know, the quality of their players is just so much higher.
Yeah, those.
I'm looking at these teams. And the worst player on this team is arguably more experienced. Well, okay, and there is Jeremy. I didn't realize Jeremy because of his silly name.
Who would you say is the What would you say the difference is between, I'm assuming you mean jazz and squash?
Maybe, I guess, yeah. Like, you could argue that those players are...
Well, the squash has 100% win rate, so can't compete with that.
In his one game that he played?
Yeah. A has an 80% win rate. Really, it's Ballas letting the team down with the lowest win rate of 62%.
Didn't see Gepru coming in there with the boost. Peter won't get past squash.
And squash, that was squash a nice return. But Doppler misses the flag.
He misses the flag. He'll just wait and probably still get the cap at this point. Jeremy comes in, but portals. Jeremy had a good angle. Had an almost good boost, but obviously he missed, so it wasn't a good boost. Seems to be the requirement for boosts being good.
By definition, yeah. It's only really
Jeremy
a
will be out
hit
here.
Him.
Boost wasn't really great, in all honesty. That rolling bomb, the tag crew is still up. That's going to be another cap. 3-0. The rolling bomb finally defused.
I didn't have Doku down for most caps. That was a rookie mistake.
Ballas hits that bomb to perfection and caps for a fourth.
It's really just not looking close. Like, the flag...
No.
When they were playing the flag bearers last week, the Balkanists didn't actually look that bad. They're looking really bad this game.
Ballas now ahead of Jeremy, but the base is fairly well organized.
I think Gebru was making a joke about how many caps there's been, yeah.
Oh. Well, he's not getting them. Jeremy picks up a rolling bomb, but it's not going to help his team stop this cap.
As much. Although, Jez could be out ahead of two here. Not likely. Well, if he had gone through the portal, then he would have had
it. He might have been, yeah.
Yeah. Kiss is good. Yeah, that stops some capping.
Balls. For now. Timmy can't hear with a grab. Be a cap. It's never going to work out for you.
They're just not holding on to that tight OD they had.
Jeremy boosts
ahead. Like, I
haven't
seen one or two on OD this whole
eight
game.
Caps easily because of it. You can't be making these crazy
flaccid
boosts.
Flaccid after flaccid after flaccid.
Oh, that was really lovely from Doku.
That was I think he's going for top plays now.
This is what Doku did to me, like, twice in our game we played on Scorpio last season. Using that boost to clear base.
Who did you guys pick for top caps?
I had Ballas.
I had Dope. Oh, no, hang on. I don't remember. I might have had...
Oh, I think I was pretty good on Ballas with him having four caps so far. He was saying earlier that five people or six people went for him, and five or six people went for A. So most of the competition went for them.
Timmy in trouble. Dokugan chasing him. Runs into squash. Jeremy just needs to stay patient.
To get out. Yeah.
He's patient, but he tries to boost past squash there and doesn't work out. He might have been better boosting top. A now ahead of two. Peter comes through the portal, it helps him out, and now Jeremy's ahead of three, but no one near Ball was to get that return.
Nearly all of Jez's grabs have ended up stopping a cap.
Doku ends up dead. Timmy's going to pick up a rolling bomb. Defused almost immediately, and he finds himself in a corner, gets returned by Doku with a nice snipe. Another nice snipe from Jeremy to get that return there. Alright, so about 5 minutes has passed. It's 8-0. It's...
A massacre.
Yeah.
It's not great.
I guess it is kind of hard to play OD on Scorpio with all the boosts.
And he sees his opportunity as Timmy comes off the portal. Now they've got this chain going again. If
I don't think they would have won many games still, but I think they would be doing an awful lot less on the captive.
Oh yeah. I think they it would have actually been a team at that point.
I still think they might have come last.
It's a 100 coin team.
Think it, yeah.
It's as the captains have rated it, I suppose. Or, well, not exactly. Captains. have been known to boost players up and play the mind games. Squash, sitting by that boost, might take it. He does, and ends up working for him. That was... I mean, in any other game, that would be risky. But it just didn't feel as risky in this game. I suppose the 8-0 lead helps out.
Once you're down by 10 caps, there's no longer any risks.
Yeah.
Like, the outcome's going to be the same either way.
You can do the backward snipes and all of that.
Boost blocks.
Pulse with an easy grab. You're going to use the bomb to get out. He's going to wait for the pup. Timmy gets the tag, bro. Bulwus gives up on that pup. Peter gets the rolling bomb. They've got all three pups this round.
They're actually leading in pups.
Now they need to get the return on Bulwus. If they can organize themselves and not commit the wrong way, then they'll get the cap. 9-1. We might as well give them a win at this point.
About to run out.
I've done it, says Gavrik.
I don't think you could ask for much more for one of your games if you're on this team.
Dokugan finds himself in a corner. Timmy Cahill with a 3 to beat.
Running back's probably not a bad idea.
Might create some space for yourself. See, he gets past Bulwus, almost gets past Squash. See, at this point they're getting complacent. I mean, it's okay to get complacent when you can't lose anymore. But... and here we go. Bulwus comes in for... Yeah.
Well, that's a cap.
Yeah, 14 to 10.
You could definitely tell it's Jeremy's team with the whole lead again pups losing 10-1. They got the important part down.
Alright, let's make this game exciting with some awesome commentary. A with a nice grab.
He's gonna be out.
Splits Timmy and Peter. He's out ahead of two. Lag.
Boost.
He's
blocks.
Boosted out by Doc. A huge cap.
Three blocks.
Now, Bulwus is gonna be ahead of just the one for the moment. He's gotta get past Timmy here. Peter comes in with the boost. He's gonna get past Timmy. He might get past Peter. The boost is there. Peter takes it.
What is
Bulwus has gone past. A now with a flag. Coming to a base. Head of three. Jeremy grabs. He might get out. He does get out. So now A's going to have to backtrack. He's going to hit the rolling bomb. Jeremy's going to want that pup. He doesn't get it. Now is a rolling bomb on A coming into a base with only two players in it. That tag bro's there. Squash going to try and push for the return. Doesn't come. The return comes now. Perfect from A.
Well done.
I forgot that A's inability to cap wouldn't transfer to this game.
Jeremy's going to be up top. Head of three, but... Return is come on Bulwus. Peter playing it safe.
Not there.
Now Peter's going to be away. He's by the boost there. Takes it down. He's ahead of three. Bulwus still with the flag. Closing in on him. He gets past Jeremy. Peter making some space for himself. He's holding the flag for longer than he has any right to, but he does get return on the end. Get flags for Squash and Gepru.
With the important stats. Well, the Baltimore's really weren't looking strong for that first minute, but they didn't completely fall apart after that, which was nice. They kind of pulled themselves together.
Yeah, that's when I looked. It was probably 8-0 for a bit longer than that.
They really just held on for a while.
I think they just took their foot off the pedal mostly.
Yeah.
So what was the score? 12-1?
Yeah.
This thing doesn't go up to 12. Or does it now? Yeah, it doesn't go up to 12.
Yeah, they literally can't go higher than 10, can they? Handicaps are stopped. Was that not the case? Because Dodds was complaining about it.
It still doesn't work. At least not here. Alright, teams are ready. Welcome to the Comeback Kings in an alternate universe. What can they make of this?
Okay. Well, red team will go faster, so the bulk miss could have a slight advantage this half.
2, 1.
Who'll get the first grab? It's hotly contested.
Jez
gets the first grab, he's out ahead of two. Boas gets past Peter and Timmy.
Also ahead of two, and in a far better position, really.
Yeah.
Although, no re. That could hurt him.
Who needs re?
A team playing someone with competent defense?
Well, I mean, do they need re if the defense is competent? It's a question we all ask ourselves.
Squash coming into the cap, but foreign base, it's probably not going to happen.
But Balls with the flag now. He won't get past Jeremy. He'll wait for Pups, but actually, no, he's just waiting for Jeremy to go and get the Pup.
Too predictable. Ooh, that's a good kiss by Peter. But that puts A out ahead of 2 with a Juke Juice. And I really don't like A with a Juke Juice.
He gets returned, and it might be
that's
a cap
hit.
It will be. Scores are not really level. They're level in this half, at least. Ah, nice night from Jeremy. Docky will
no
be out.
No handicaps, right? That means that no one capped last half.
Clearly.
Ooh, Docky had a very close
Gepri with a chance of hitting this bomb right. He does not hit the bomb right.
Putting A out ahead of 1. Probably 2 if he hits this boost. Which he does
straight not. Straight into Gepri. Peter now out ahead of 3. Squash getting ahead.
Ball's
Peter hits the wall, slows him down a little bit. Bolas not getting
he's
returned.
He's cornered, yeah. Jez boosts straight into Gepri. Gepri's just a magnet.
One day he'll choose himself for most returns and he'll be right.
He's playing O, and he should clearly be playing D, because he's playing well.
Jeremy almost gets that juke, just doesn't quite pay off. Peter and Timmy aren't going to push too hard here because the return came very quickly.
Ooh.
And now Squash with a rolling bomb.
And that's a
taken
kiss.
Out. Peter needs to get the hell out of there. Gepri's got blocks
and
on Ballas.
Another kiss.
He goes for the kiss.
Pisses.
Gepri now cornered by Ballas, and there's no one there. That'll be another cap. Ballas now coming in. 2-on-2 blocks. Doesn't go the way they blocked.
Jez accusing someone else of timers? That's a nice change. A is really getting a lot of gaps. I feel betrayed.
Another cap. Makes it 5-1 this half, which gives it, what, a total of 17-2?
Yep.
Glorious.
The impressive part, though, was the Borgmans got the first cap. That's all it counts. Yes, it's a little bit of a blowout.
Peter with a nice boost to get that return on Boris. A,
no.
Barney is time, just so he can juke Peter. Didn't need to juke Peter, he chose to juke Peter. He could have gone past him quite easily. Boas. Waiting. He'll get past Timmy. Some blocks from A. He'll get past Peter. No blocks required. Squash got some blocks on Jeremy. Doc gun. Might have some blocks here as well. Ballas tries to go against the back wall, but just misses it. He's going to pick up a rolling bomb, though. Now's a great chance for him, but Timmy might actually be out here. He's got the boost, too. He will be out. And that'll be a return there as well. So Timmy's gone flag, bro. But A is going to be out. He's going to juke Jeremy. Just the once. Almost twice. Now Timmy's ahead of two, but no one's near Ballas. He returns himself. Now Squash is going to try and edge past Peter, maybe? No, he goes backwards. Peter waits by the portal, and they do get that return. Gepru is near the flag tile, but A has the flag, so that's not going to be a cap, as the rules of Tag Pro determined. A goes for a split for fun, doesn't pay off for him.
Ballas could easily be out here.
Jeremy has deserted the pup. He might not want to go back to get it. Doesn't know it's there, he gets returned instead. Gepru will get the pup. It's a rolling bomb at top right. Picks it up at 34. That rolling bomb is defused now as Gepru goes to the portal. Gepru gets returned with a nice boost. Nice snipe. A just messing around with Jeremy at this point. He tries to come into a base. Timmy commits and he gets the return. Squash could have maybe waited a couple of seconds and just squeezed past three of them. Ends up getting returned instead. Now A is going to be coming to a base. Gepru grabs the flag. No one's there to return him, so A will have to wait a little bit longer.
Gepru seems pretty safe right now, but it's not going to take much to dislodge.
He doesn't want the rolling bomb, so Squash grabs it instead. Jeremy easily predicted by Docker Gun.
And that Squash out of three with an RB.
Yeah. He jukes Gepru, and it won't be a cap.
That's Peter with an RB out of three.
Peter is out.
Returns cap for a second.
Be
not
good.
Anymore.
Nah. Squash. So much space for him right now. A's out. Arcane is in.
What I wanted.
Is he lagging or is it just, you know,
he
want to give Arcane a go?
He was complaining about it earlier.
There goes my prediction.
Squash almost hits that spike. Just managed to avoid it. Jeremy's pushing Timmy into the corner.
He wants that pup.
And they're fighting each other over the pup.
It's only
not
20
good teamwork,
seconds away.
Really?
Good guess, and that's Ballas with an RB.
Yeah,
Jess is finally
going to
get that
good
pup. Yep, and that's Ballas with the cap.
And Docker Gun gets the pup.
Well, at least he fought for it. That's what counts. It's all about the battle, you know, not who wins.
The only person he fought was himself.
His team. That's different.
He is his team at this point. If we're being honest.
That's harsh on Gepru.
I mean, Gepru's got 9 points right now. Like, Arcane's almost beat him.
Yeah, but look at all those pops. You can tell they were helping the team out.
I believe Gepru did get a cap in the first half, though.
No, he didn't.
Ballas. No,
the
he
team did.
No, Gepru got that cap. It was all Gepru.
I think he was just excited because the team did. And that's cap for
Gepru
Ballas.
Takes the non-conservative option.
Backward snipes are always the best option, though. Okay, that's probably a good kiss. Destroys the Tapra lead. But Peter is still out ahead of three. And that's ahead of four. Return is going to be capped for a bit.
Return's going to be a cap forever at this point. But Arcane gives up on blocking to try and get this return. And Squash runs a ring around him and gets the return. Ballas gets returned. So what, 8-1, 20-2 at this point?
Yeah, well, he wouldn't let him trade for Diggs 10 seconds before the game started. When Rain wasn't there. The nerve.
Scapper out ahead of four.
So I guess Squash, like, they're back. Come off Reid.
This couldn't get it quick enough. Peter is out. Peter is for back.
Kale's not kiss, but I guess Tape will lead.
Gepru.
There's no pressure on Timmy right now.
Spiked with a lovely boost. Timmy won't get that. Bolas comes and ruins his chance of juking Squash.
Return, honestly. Ooh, Bolas can't block for shit. Demo was right.
Alright, 20-2.
Pathetic. That's not even near a record.
Alright, well, that's it for the first game. Now you've got Star.
There won't be as many caps on that, hopefully. Although it is very easy to get a few in when they're out of position. Jesus, and they've been out of position a lot. Yeah. Really weird lag as fuck playing.
Formation is important on Star as well. Just being aware of your surroundings. It's not a big map, so it's pretty easy to know where people are if you're communicating.
I'd recommend they just spend the whole time on OD. But I don't know how that'll work out. I'm pretty sure they would actually still win a 3v4 on Star.
Well, if they agree to it, then they can do that.
I don't know why they would. What's Jez talking about? Being allowed to use timers? Was that in regards to Rain playing on someone else's laptop, or was that in regards to the Maxophon thing where it does something different?
Hang on. Who said what now? I'm disabling my script and turning on timers. Apparently that's allowed now. That's probably with the Maxlon thing. Which, Docker Gun wasn't supposed to tell anybody.
What do you mean he wasn't supposed to tell anybody?
Because you tell one person that one person has being given an exception for using thing, which obviously sounds fucking shady as fuck. And you know, uproar is expected. There's really not much we can do except for like, what? Force someone to play in a laggy browser that they don't really ever play on.
I kind of want to change to Maxophon, actually.
You can do it next season? Maybe not. I don't know. Well, we're trying to get it fixed for Maxophon right now.
I can't stream on Chrome anymore because I can't play Tag Pro or watch Tag Pro without hardware acceleration or it fucks up. And you can't stream with hardware acceleration because OBS doesn't work with it.
Good old OBS.
I mean, ping blocks is they get 18 ping to Tag Pro, so clearly some of it's from somewhere else.
Balkmists are ready. It's a clean slate for them into this game. So there's, you know, a 50-50 chance that they can win. Mathematically. I know Doku loves his 50-50s.
What's going on here? Why haven't we started?
They're just waiting for A. They want to play their best team against this strong opposition. Now we're ready to go. Just, you know, cover the chokes and get the gate and you can't lose.
Well, if they just have, like, two people on the bot button and then two people sitting top, there's no way to get through. Like, they can control both buttons, no one get past, easy. Yeah, Sumble gets it. Okay, that's a nice early flaccid from Jez. And Bulwus is now out ahead at 2. Can make that no longer.
Alright, well, things are looking promising. 30 seconds have passed and the scores are still 0-0.
Ah, disappointing. That's my 4 caps.
Now the bombs are going to come up.
Yeah. Although,
chance for Timmy here, he'll get past, he'll go top. If he can get this right, he takes it wrong.
Do Bulwus and A still remember how to play OD? That's going to be A go on.
Yeah, now the pups are coming up.
Okay, Jez will probably get that one. Never mind. They lost all the pups.
2 Juke Juices to Charlie Sheen. Jeremy uses the bomb to try and maybe guide the flag or make some space for a teammate, but misses everybody. Was lucky to stay alive, really.
And that's going to be now, A's easily out. Top. Or not, I guess. If he doesn't want to be.
He can take his time, really. They've got mid now, and mid's the best way to approach. Because there's no choke in mid. Just the spikes, which in turn form like 1,000 chokes.
Which are just as dangerous for everyone. But it's also the place where if you fuck up, it's most likely to help killing the flag carrier.
Another 2 pups to Charlie Sheen.
Total control.
They do have total control of the pups. Now they have a tag pro lead going bottom. And really, this should be a standard cap for them.
Yep.
And it is. So I'm not sure what Gepri's doing at bottom. Maybe he was like trying to line up the boost to come back in, but accidentally disabled it. No one knows what goes on in Gepri's mind. Bulwus almost takes that corner well enough to get past. A takes out Peter on the gate. It's like he was expecting him to come up.
Holds the gate. I don't see how he can make that happen.
Well, now they'll get pups.
Yep, Timmy knows where
Timmy,
he's going, though.
Perfect.
I think he was just trying to bounce back for the pup himself, but ended up getting a bit lucky. And that's just
He goes in
long.
Too quick. You go in that quick, you can't turn. Everyone knows that.
Did they scrim? Half of them ever played Star before?
Oh, Docker Gun. Almost. Well, I suppose he half butchered that boost. Almost works out for Gepri, but doesn't get the ricochet quite right. Timmy and Gepri were like playing OD while they don't have the flag. Not making much attempt to try and grab at this point. Probably just waiting for the pups. But even then, they're in bad positions for that. Timmy's gonna grab. He's gonna get out. He's gonna try and go through the spikes. But now Bulwus is there, so that's not gonna happen. And Squash is all positioned on the gate as well. He can cover top, he can cover gate. Timmy's only option is to get some help from Gepper or go bottom. Now things are not looking good. They are not looking good at all for the Borkmists. Now it's 2-0.
Like, even when the scores were even, did you really have hopes they could win?
You always have hope.
True. I mean, Doku could do some stupid bomb blocks.
Bulwus hits the bomb well, coming in top blocks from Squash, but Gepru and Jeremy are there. Jeremy commits, and that is... Timmy commits hard, and... he is thanking Gepru. He's giving him all his prayers for avoiding that embarrassment, getting into the... do we have, like, a top five worst plays?
I don't think we even have a top five players in general, dude.
That's just... the good old days. That really worked well for Timmy there.
When people put effort into OTP.
Yeah, when people put effort. Man, I remember when the commissioners put in effort. Now they don't do anything.
Hoog's always been a commissioner, as far as I can remember.
Yeah. Jeremy and A decide not to take the boost. A mutual agreement. Jeremy just playing around in the spikes, trying to, you know, waste a bit of time. Just to,
it's
you know.
It's pretty good jokes, really. I feel like that's become hard to be jokes, because a lot of time, even when it's a good idea to kiss, it might not be.
It's always a good idea to kiss. Unless they've got, mouth herpes or something.
Split ups.
Ooh, it's not looking good for Peter. He needs to hit this right. And he had the right idea, but just didn't have the right execution.
Probably didn't know how to do it. I'm pretty sure they haven't scrimmed. And as far as I know, Gepru, Peter, and Timmy are all... No, Timmy's not new, but... fairly new players, and Timmy's just inactive.
Peter commits a little too hard. Let's Bulwus get away top. And Bulwus uses that corner boost to change momentum and get this cap. Peter can't quite survive long enough to get to that boost, and A is through mid. Bulwus forces Jeremy onto the flag, gets the return, and that's a cap for A. So now they begin to run away with it, with 3 minutes remaining. Dokugan should be covering the bottom here, almost. They have the tag proven base already. But, doesn't matter, they'll get the cap anyway.
Hard not to with two tag present style.
Yeah, but if they had the boost from behind, they could have easily put a nice snipe and got the return, just...
Didn't it defuse it on its way past them?
No. It was. Oh. It spawned as they went past, and tag went in to switch back, and but didn't, and it worked out fine for them anyway. Gepru knows how to hit that boost. He's showing everyone a masterclass in O. But he eventually does get returned. That's going to be a tag for a lead. Squash providing it for Bulwus. Peter providing it for Timmy. And
Squash is
abandoning Bulwus. Now Bulwus has returned. Timmy fakes out. He just can't wait there long enough to get through. Get through rounds with Gepru.
Can't get through Gepru.
He's invincible. Speaking of, Gepru is just waiting around for, I don't know, the bomb, I guess. And now A is going to be ahead of...
More than one.
Ahead of two. And Jeremy...
And Bulwus left Ree to get a pop. At all the wrong timing. Someone should probably head back, but... Oh, yep, they're going for Turtle and Strats. They can't lose by any more, then.
Yeah, you gotta do Turtles right, though.
Yeah, it wasn't the best Turtle I've ever seen. And Doctor's gonna be out here.
Best place to do a Turtle, either.
I mean, it's not terrible for this map.
You wanna go near the pup.
Yeah.
In that corner behind the spike.
I'm still allowed him to use the bomb if something went horribly wrong, and then still probably come out of it okay. And he's just waiting for that return, and if it happens, that's a cap.
6 seconds left.
Peter nearly kills himself.
We kept flags for A and Peter. Nope, not for Peter.
But no cap? No cap. He died, but not in time for a cap. That .25 gets him. Little known fact that the .25 applies if you're on the tile, like after it's returned, but not if you move on to the tile within .25 seconds.
That is a fun fact.
I'm sorry, I don't have any yelp ones. And unfortunately Doc was playing.
Does it score like 8-0? Seven nil. Who are these people? Away you go.
Maybe they're just fourth.
Who are we kicking? Diggs. Bye, Diggs.
And what did he ever do?
Alright. It's only 8-0. 7-0.
Yeah.
Even better. They're practically winning.
Hoog.
Hey,
can
Pat.
Can I go into the ball commiss room and on Mumble and give them tips? Is that against
no,
the rule?
No, definitely not.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's
oh, so we can't
worse.
Give... Oh, so
you
we're not allowed
now.
To give
You've
any
like
tips.
You've got like 8 seconds to do it.
You can't Wait. Actually give them advice during the game.
You can do it in the break, though, but it's too late
okay.
now.
While I was kicked, I wasn't even talking.
Oh, yeah. Like, just like you weren't even joining.
As Gepru, we're on to you. I'm pretty sure they swapped accounts.
Oh, man, it's opened up a little just for a few seconds there. Timmy with the anti-ray. Works for him, but two flaccids and all his hard work has not paid off, and now he's been smash into a spike. And Dave's out ahead of four. Doku has the blocks. That is 8-0 now. So I knew it was 8-0. I knew before it happened.
Well, you claim it's going to end 8-0?
No, it was going to be 8-0 at one point. I was just like a minute ahead of everyone else. Boris almost snuck through between Peter and Gepru.
That's a tag for lead with an RB.
Yeah.
It's not going to go well.
It's going to go really well for Charlie Sheen. You would hope. And it does. Rolling bomb untouched.
Another fun fact. RBs actually low-key increase your juking ability by 53%.
Really? Is that so? Know what I'm writing my thesis on now. Does rolling bomb increase juking ability? Some, like, psychology thing?
Yeah. It's impossible to hit someone with an RB.
Okay, I don't believe that. I've hit people with RBs before.
They probably weren't people. They're probably pub players.
Probably bots.
I tried to pub at that one pier and then there were three sun balls on.
So open for him.
Pretty sure they're all bots.
That rolling ball makes space. Boris is making sure there's enough space between him and Doku so he doesn't get knocked to a spike.
It's a good call.
Another cap if A hits this right, which he does not, but he gets the cap anyway. I suppose that's right, he didn't really lose much momentum. So I shouldn't trash on him for that, that was actually okay. Okay, that was not okay, that was awful, A, what the fuck were you thinking? it's 11-0. But, it's not the end of the world. There's still next week. You guys are playing my team. And now A is going to come into a base where it's 2v1 blocks. Jeremy doesn't even bother. Doku gets the juke juice. Gepru gets the juke juice. Boris is going to be coming in top. He can hit this boost right. He hits it perfectly. Squashed with some fantastic blocks. And they're beginning to run away with this game, if they weren't already. A with blocks again, another cap.
Oh boy. So that's 3 for A. Guess A's gonna get the most caps for the week.
A.
I was really relying on Boris. Yeah, fucking Jez is finally paying attention to Pat's advice. Good strat, Jez. Good strat. That's on stream, yeah? You have chat on, Finn? Oh, well, in chat, Jez said, Pat said for us to play 4OD. Let's have Nanum play really well.
Bants, I suppose.
Is it? I mean, they've got no OD.
Yeah, but they're not playing very well. I think he's trying to say Pat gives bad advice.
Yeah, he's cap for
clearly just making a joke, so no point making a joke to Timmy Cahill and Peter and Gepru. And they're the only ones that'll hear it, so why bother? Balls will get returned, hopefully.
Well, I'm not, they'll take it as legitimate advice.
I mean, that's legitimate advice. Any advice is legitimate advice. Another cap.
Nice boost from Boris there.
That was the exact boost AJ a while ago that I said was bad.
Yeah, but there were people in the way this time.
Yeah.
Like, if he had done what A should have done, he would have died. That gets Boris a juke juice and A, RB.
Middle opened up for him. Didn't need to take it though.
And Boris kills himself like a fool.
Spawn was a bit awkward. A is waiting for gate. Squash comes and provides the gate. A jukes Peter. Doesn't juke Timmy. Jeremy gets returned. Squash grabs the flag. Timmy gets the return. Bolt goes mid. Peter grabs the flag. A gets the return. Jeremy forces the flag. Boris gets cap. Riverton commentary. A with a great snipe on squash. Now squash is out mid. So they've got 11 caps this half. Oh boy. Makes it 12. One last roll of the dice. No. Doku and Jeremy with the flag. Jeremy's gonna go through mid. Manages to squeeze out of there before Doku gets the button.
I really didn't think Star was gonna go higher than Scorpio. But it probably will. I mean, it is now, isn't it? Because it was 20 to 2, and now it's 19 to 1.
Yeah. The margin is bigger at the moment. But you never know, they might get another cap.
Maybe if Ball was DC's instead of A this time. That's going to be a cap for squash, I think.
Funny. Yeah. 13. 13! Boris has the flag. Gets past Timmy and Peter and has timers because he got that boost. Because, you know, nobody ever just goes in the safe option in case the boost spawns. That's ridiculous. Timmy almost pushing himself into trouble. He's going to get through mid now. Now, A could be in trouble, but, you know, he takes the smart option and boosts backwards. And runs straight into Peter.
Squash is going to be out ahead of two top, but that boost is going to spawn on him. And he fucked it. And that is like the third time I've seen Bulwus leave Re when it just would have been a really easy cap if he had stayed for 2 seconds.
Might still be an easy cap for him.
I mean, he would have had the RB with the flag if he had just waited for the flag to come up before running off for the RB. It's probably a cap for Doku. No. Good grab.
A bounces off the corner of the wall, grabs the flag, maintains his momentum. 2v2 blocks. Jeremy gets back in time. But Timmy's still going to get returned. A is going to come in 2v3 blocks. And they work. In no situation should that ever happen.
Well,
if you outnumber the defense, you can't. No. Your OD must win. It must. It's the rule.
Okay, Bolus is out at a 4, returns cap. That's it.
22-0 is the score right now. There's 22 seconds left. Jeremy is just... What do you do?
Well, that's probably the score of 22-0.
Cap flag for Doku and Peter.
Oh, that's what counts. Oh, that's probably A for the most caps this week. And if this half is indicative, that's squash for most returns.
Perhaps. Maybe someone else got more returns in another game.
Maybe. You're right, that is technically possible.
We can't just assume, like, all the things that happen in the games against the Borgists.
Why not again?
I mean, you can with like 95% accuracy, but...
Yeah. To be fair, I think everyone who did that last week was wrong, so... I think it just wasn't a very good game for them. Let's drag one of them in and then ask them a bunch of pointed questions.
No, that just doesn't seem like it's going to go down well.
I could see them winning against Bobby's team. They haven't played them yet, have they?
Oi.
I mean, they've got Hoog on D. Can't do much worse.
Hoog plays O now.
Did you guys do pretty well last week, though? Last night, when Demo DC'd?
Demo DC'd, so...
I couldn't believe they didn't have a sub.
And, I mean, even if you discount the caps that we got then, I think we still won.
But
it's more than that. It's momentum and stuff like that, so... Oh, good game, good stream, thanks for watching. And we'll bring you, I don't know, miners tomorrow, maybe? On this channel, I don't know. I don't know what Vin does in his spare time.
Yeah, miners. Currently best thing in the whole of OLTP. Just saying.
Woo! Well, assuming the stream's still going, which I don't actually know. Thanks for watching, everyone. That was OLTP for the week.
It's coming back tomorrow.
What?
Coming back tomorrow.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Woo!
Wait, there's a miners competition this season?
Yes. I'm second best player.
Yeah, I know. Just joking.
To be honest, there isn't much competition, but... Yeah, the boys.